Hello students, today we will discuss about JEE Mains 2015 physics paper. Now we will discuss all the questions one by one. Okay, let us start. Now question number 1, JEE Mains paper. The first question says, two stones are thrown out simultaneously from the edge of a cliff 240 meter high with initial speed of 10 meter per second and 40 meter per second. So two stones are thrown with different speeds given. Which of the following graph best represents time variation of relative position? Relative position means as one is thrown up, the other is thrown up simultaneously, obviously, and the position of one with respect to the other. So if you sit at one stone and observe the other stone, that is called the relative position. Then the variation of relative position of second stone with respect to the first. The assumptions made is stones do not rebound after hitting the ground and neglect air resistance. G is 10 meter per second square. The figures are schematic and not drawn to scale. Now, basically, we have got four options. Obviously, the stone which was thrown with 10 meter per second will come to the ground first, then 40. So, the life of this first stone will be common to both the particles. That means suppose, and as you can see here from the diagram, let us first we have to find the life of this 10 meter per second stone. And so long as the first stone will be in air, during that time the second stone also will be in air, but it will not touch the ground. After that, this second stone will fall accelerating. So as far as the during that time, we don't know that time for what time this is in air. So first we'll find the time, then during that time the equation will be mostly a straight line, because one with respect to the other, though both are in free fall condition, so one observation one with respect to another will be a straight line, that will also derive. So this part of the graph is correct, but then how far it will be straight line? It will be straight line, so any of the four is possible, but then we have to check after what to what time the first stone is in motion, whether it is 8 or 12. If it is 8, then we have three options left. And then after the first stone hits the ground, the second stone will be only accelerating, because the second stone is in motion. The first stone is at rest, so it is a free fall condition, it will be accelerating. So then we know that for accelerating, this is a case. This is not possible, this is not possible. So without solving, I hope that this is the answer, but then we have to solve it. So let us solve it. The first stone, the velocity is 10. The second one, so velocity is 40 meter per second. Now, the height of the cliff is 240 meters. Now, I just want to find the the life of this first stone. This is first stone, and this is second stone. This is the ground, this is the height of the cliff. Now we know that the we'll use the equation S is ut plus half a t square equation we can use, and from this equation we can find the time for which this will be in air. Now this S, finally this has to come down to this point. So therefore, if I choose this as the origin, then this is the final displacement, So final displacement is 240 minus, because this is the origin I choose here. So therefore this is minus, so this will be minus 240. U is your 10, t I have to find. A acceleration is minus 10, because in the question this is given you take 10, so it is minus half into 10 into t square. If I take a 0 0 0 cancels out, then it will be t square by 2 minus t, 10 cancels out, and minus 24 equals to 0. From here I'll write t square minus 2t minus 48 equals to 0. So this is I have to solve it. 8 6 are 48, so I'll write this is 80 plus 60, this is minus 2, and product will be 48 t square minus 48 equals 0. So t is t minus 8 plus 6 t minus 8 0. So from here t minus 8 t plus 6 0, from here t equals to 8 or minus 6. So see, this negative 6 second is not considered. You have to consider this one. Might be the negative 6 second means that the time to cover this might be possible, that this is the time before, if it was thrown not from here, then from here on the ground itself, then from here to here it would have taken 6 seconds. So that is in minus, that is the physical meaning, but this is not required. So our motion is from here to the ground, so t is equal to 8 seconds. That means for t equal to 8 seconds, this particle will be somewhere just about hit the ground and still in motion, and this will be somewhere, I don't know where, but somewhere will be there. Then so for t equals to 8 seconds, both of them are in motion, and therefore with one with respect to other, it should be a straight line. Let us see whether it is a straight line. And I have to use another paper, just use that. Now if I use y2 equals to u t minus half g t square, and y1 equals to u1 t minus half g t square. These are the equation we are using for 8 seconds. For first 8 seconds, the time will be same. And if I subtract this, y2 minus y1 is u2t minus u1t, this will cancel out. So that equals to u2 minus u1 into t minus y1. So y2 minus y1 is 40 minus 10, that is 30t. y2 minus y1 is 30t. This is equation number 1. If I see the question, the y2 minus y1 is on y-axis and t is on x-axis. So you can easily see that the difference y2 minus y1, y2 minus y1 means the position or displacement of y1 with respect to y2. Now y2 minus y1 is this. So if this is taken in y direction, y axis, and this is in time in t axis, this is in y axis. So I will say if this is y, and then this is mx, some 30 into t, this is the slope, something like that. Or this will happen up to t equals to 8 second. This is of the form y is proportional to x, or y equals to mx with, this is 0, this is the y intercept being 0, so it should pass through origin until 8 seconds. If I see the options, then 1, 2, 3, these three are possibilities. But then logically what we have to do is, now obviously as it is shown for 12 seconds, that might be possible, it is possible that the second one will land after 12 seconds. But even then, I don't have to calculate that whether it is landing actually after 12 seconds as shown in the graph. But then I will think of what happens that the first one lands the ground and the second one is somewhere here. This is the first one, this is the second one somewhere here, and it has to cover still a lot of distance. Then if this is one and this is two, then what is the position of variation of this difference of y, the displacement of this with respect to this. Now this will be accelerated motion because this is already at rest and this is accelerating downward. So this will be a accelerated motion, and and its speed is increasing. When speed is increasing and the slope is negative because the acceleration is downward is negative. So I'll think of plotting the graph after this. As so we have to reach 12 seconds. So how to reach 12 seconds after this? So I can have three choices: this way, this way, or this way. I can reach this 12 seconds. But then which one is correct? This will not be correct because this means that it's constant velocity. The slope of this graph gives you the velocity. It is a constant velocity, which is not there because this is accelerating. So either this one or this one will be the answer. Now which one will be the answer? Both are given to us. See here, this one also given, this is also given. This is not correct, this is rejected because it's not possible. Then the other two we have to choose. From these two, then we know that it is accelerating downwards, so slope should be negative. The velocity is also negative, should be negative. The velocity is negative and slope should be negative. So here the slope is negative, but then we will think of because it is accelerating, the velocity is increasing, accelerating and increasing. Then in that case we have the equation s is equal to ut plus half t square, ut plus half t square. Then the graph will be something like parabolic one. Then it should be of this type, because it should be of this type. So this is correct because if you take the slope, it's negative here. You can see here. So you can see this is how the slope is. Slope is increasing. That means velocity is increasing, and the slope is negative. That means velocity is negative because it is downward direction. So therefore, this would be the correct option. It should be parabolic in this. So therefore, if I look at the option, then this one up to 8 seconds, it will be straight line, and the first will be seen as moving in a parabolic path with respect to the second one. So this is the correct option. Okay, thank you.